Hey kids, once again it's Mr. Daddy's coming with you with another great Bible lesson. Today we're going to learn another lesson about God and the greatness of God, but today something's different. Can you guess what's different? Look behind you. I'm at the beach, I'm on vacation, but there is no vacation from God. So I'm going to give you this lesson today. I know you'll be blessed. And it's great something, and it's something that you want to learn and you want to tell everybody about. Look at that. Look at those waves. Look at the sand. There's birds all around me trying to get food. Let's concentrate on today's lesson. You ready? Okay. Today's lesson is God helps David do his jobs. The scripture is 1 Samuel 16:11, verses 18 through 21. And 1 Samuel 17, verses 34 through 37. The focus is we can trust God to help us do our jobs. And the Bible memory verse is Psalm 124, 8. We'll get to that at the end. All right. Before we get started, let's do the things that we always do. It's three things that we do. First thing that we do, we get rid of all our distractions. We turn off the TV. We stop watching videos except for this one. You put the dog out, the cat out, the mouse out, the bird out, a dragonfly out, mosquitoes out. We put everything out to keep our distractions. The second thing we do is you get your family, the people in your house, to come watch this video. So you get your mother, your father, your grandmother, your grandfather, your brothers, your sisters. You tell them to come in. Mr. Thad has another video, and guess what? He is at the beach, and we're gonna watch this video together. The third thing I want you to do, the most important thing is, I need you to get your Bible. Guess what? I have my Bible. So, this is what I want you to do. I want you to go get your Bible. I'm gonna give you 10 seconds. You ready? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, you got your Bible? Okay, before we start and we really get into this, we're going to pray. So I want you to close your eyes and bow your head and let's pray. Ready? All right. Father God, we thank you for this beautiful, wonderful day at the beach, Lord God. We thank you for giving us the Bible, Lord God, and the words to live by. Father God, we pray that this lesson will bless everybody that hears it. Hears it and opens their ears and opens their heart to learn what you want us to learn today, Lord God. Father God, we thank you for your wonderful creation and most importantly, your son, Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, amen. Okay. All right, so we've got that. We prayed. We got a Bible. We got rid of distractions. We got our family members. Let's get into today's lesson. So, today we're going to talk about jobs that kids do. You know, what are some of the jobs that kids do? Well, when I was little, my mother used to make me do the dishes, which is put them in a dishwasher, which I hated. I had to vacuum. And my father used to make me cut the grass and rake the leaves, which I hated raking leaves, but I did it anyway because my father asked me. So what are some of the jobs that you do? Some of you may fold your own clothes. Some of you may wash your own clothes. Some of you may do your brother's or your sister's hair. Some of you may clean the bathroom. So kids have all kinds of different jobs that they do. So when you do these jobs, who are you helping? Well, when you're at home, you're helping your mother and your father. You're helping, if you're doing something for your brother and sister, you're helping them. And when it's time to do these jobs, what are you learning? Well, who helps you learn? Well, your parents help you learn, but you learn how to do these things for yourself. So when you get older, you'll be able to do it. All right, now. What are some other jobs that kids can do besides in the house? Well, you can do jobs at school. You can help the teacher pass out papers. You can be a crossing guard. You can be, I think they have line leaders and things like that. You can help the teacher. When I was little, everybody wanted to erase the board. Well, you don't have chalk and chalk boards anymore, but I wanted to erase the board. In doing all these jobs, what happens if you don't do these jobs well? Well, if you don't do the jobs well, they don't get done. And then somebody else has to come behind and do them. That's why it's always good when it's time to do a job to learn how to do it, have somebody show you, and then do it the best you can. So you can do it right the first time.
Right.
So it is important for kids to do their jobs well. Today we're going to learn that we can trust God to help us do our jobs. Yes, we can. All right. So let's get into today's lesson. All right. So today's lesson comes from the book of 1 Samuel. So is it 1 Samuel in the Old Testament or the New Testament? If you think it's in the Old Testament, raise your right hand. If you think it's in the New Testament, raise your left hand. If you're not sure what book it is in, but you think, man, to be sure it's pretty, raise both hands. So what's the answer? If you put up your right hand, that's the answer. Okay, so, book of 1 Samuel is in the Old Testament, and I'm going to turn to 1 Samuel 16:11. So I'm gonna open my Bible. The 1 Samuel 16:11, and I'm going to read. Ready? Okay, it says, "And Samuel said to Jesse, are all the young men here? Then he said, there remains yet the youngest. There he is, keeping the sheep. And Samuel said to Jesse, send and bring him, for we will not sit down till he comes here. Amen." All right. So, book of Samuel, 1 Samuel, Samuel chapter 16, in the Old Testament. All right, here's the background. Samuel had anointed David to be the next king of Israel. But David didn't become the king of Israel right away. David was still young, he was still a kid. God knew David wasn't ready to be king yet, but God was going to help prepare David for the job he wanted to do later. Here's something to pay attention to. Whenever there's something that God wants you to do, he will always prepare you and send people to teach you how to do it. He will never send you to do anything if you are not prepared to do it. God does not do failure, he only does success, and he wants you to be a success. All right, let's go. So, while David was living with his family, David had one main job. Can anybody tell me what it is? Can you guess? He was a shepherd. A shepherd is somebody who takes care of the sheep. David take care of the sheep that belonged to his father. David made sure the sheep had grass to eat and water to drink. He led them to pastures where they could rest. And David also kept the sheep safe. If a bear or a lion came and carried off the sheep, David would go after the wild animal, hit it, and rescue the sheep from its mouth. If the lion or the bear then turned on David, David wasn't scared. David would seize the animal by its hair, strike it, and kill it. David was pretty good at that. David knew he didn't have the strength to do it by himself. God was helping David do his job. Later, David had other jobs. David played a lyre, which is kind of like a harp. It's like a U-shape, and it's got a bar on the top and the strings, and you pluck it like that. David was really good at that. King Saul heard about David's skills and sent messengers to David's father, Jesse, requesting that David be sent to the king. While serving the king, one of David's jobs was to play music on the lyre whenever the king was not feeling well. So whenever the king was down and not feeling well, he would say, David, can you come play the lyre? David would play the lyre. The king felt better. King Saul was pleased with David's service. Soon David was given another job. He became one of the king's armor bearers. This job would help prepare David for leading armies in the future. David trusted God, and God helped David do his jobs. God gave David the strength and the courage to do his job as a shepherd. And then God helped David as he served King Saul. So remember, when you get a little job and you don't think it's such a great job, don't despise the little job. Don't be upset. Your little job is preparing you to do greater jobs in the future, and that's what happened to David. So that is the lesson. So, we have the lesson. Now it's time to go into our often imitated, never duplicated, amen or uh-uh, where we, after listening to this lesson, I'm going to say something about the lesson. If it's true, you'll nod your head and say, amen, amen. But if it's false, you'll say, uh-uh. All right, here we go. First point. When Samuel anointed David to be king, David marched right inside and took King Saul off the throne, and David said, I'm king. Amen or uh-uh? Mm-mm, that's not true. That's not true. When Saul anointed David to be king, David didn't become king right away. All right. So, next one. When David was living with his family, David had one job to do. And that job was, David was a professional bowler. David did bowling at his father's house. He set up the pins. He got a coat. No, he did not. David was a shepherd. The shepherd took care of the sheep. Here's the next one. When something attacked the sheep, like a bear or a lion, David would go up to it, hit it, take the sheep out of his mouth, and if the lion or the bear attacked David, David would kill him. Amen or uh-uh? Amen, that's true. David did do that. That is true. That's what David did. Okay, the next one. When David went to go live with King Saul, whenever the king was upset, he would call for David. And David would tell him jokes. David would say, knock, knock. And King Saul would say, who's there? And then David said, don't you? And King said, don't you who? And then David said, don't you wish you knew what this knock-knock joke was about? Amen or uh-uh? Uh-uh, that's not true. First of all, I don't even think they had knock-knock jokes back then. And second of all, David's job was not to tell jokes. David's job was to play the lyre to cheer up King Saul. Okay, another one. After David did such a good job playing the harp, King Saul gave him another job, which is to be an armor bearer to prepare David to lead the armies into battle. Amen or uh-uh? Amen, that's true, that's true. He did do that, that's true. He did do that. All right, last one. After God got through preparing David for all of his jobs, God said, you know what, David? You did an okay job, but I'm going to send you back home. Amen. That's not true. That's not true. That's not true. God prepared David to do those jobs, and he helped David to serve King Saul as God prepared David to become king himself. Okay. All right. That's it. That is the lesson. All right. So, let's go. Oh, one more thing. Bible memory verse. I'm going to say the verse, and I'm going to want you to repeat it, okay? You say it first. It's from Psalm 124, verse 8, which is in the Old Testament. Just listen to me. I'm going to say it. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. All right, I'm going to say it again. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I'm going to say it, and then you say it, all right? Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Say it again. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. One more time, all together. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. All right, that's today's lesson. So, God helps us and prepares us with our jobs. I want you to remember that whatever job you're given by a parent or a teacher or adult, I want you to do the best you can do. Know that God will give you everything you need to do to equip you to do the job, and he's preparing you for bigger and better things. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for this lesson, Lord God. Father God, thank you for reminding us that you prepare us to do all things, Lord God. Whenever we're given a job, no matter how big or how small, you're given the job to prepare us for something greater. Father God, we thank you for this lesson, Lord God. We thank you for your creation.